Hello everyone, I welcome you all to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install WAMP Server in your Windows 10 operating system. So let's begin. Now to install WAMP Server, first you need to download WAMP Server, right? So for that, just go to your favorite browser. And now one more thing, this is basically our website Geeky Script. Here you will get many tutorials along with some blogs that I have written. So do check out our website. And today is 8th of March, so I just wanna take this opportunity to wish all of my female viewers a very very happy International Women's Day. Stay blessed and stay safe. Now let's begin our WAMP Server installation. So for that, just simply type WAMP download for Windows, enter, and here you'll be seeing this www.wampserver.com is basically our first search result. So just simply click on that, and now we'll be greeted with this WAMP Server official website. So here what I'll be doing is I'll be just, you know, simply clicking on this download button so that, you know, you go to this WAMP Server. So here basically two options, one is WAMP Server 64-bit and WAMP Server 32-bit. So my computer is a 64-bit operating system, so what I'll be doing is I'll be downloading 64-bit. If you have a 32-bit operating system, then you just simply go ahead with this 32-bit option. I am going to click on the 64-bit. Now just simply click on you can download it directly, so that, you know, you don't require to sign up all these things. And here you'll be seeing the SourceForge website has been rightly opened, and you'll be getting this download latest version link. It's 465 MB, so just simply click on that, and now you'll be seeing that your download will start shortly. So it will start downloading after 5 seconds, and here as you can see, this WAMP Server is now currently downloading. I have already downloaded it, so I'll be just simply, you know, cancel this and simply go to our download directory. And in here, as you can see, this WAMP Server 3.2.3 has been, you know, rightly downloaded over here. So for installation, just simply, you know, double click on it. I'll be just minimizing this download directory, and now as you can see, this setup wizard has been rightly opened, and the default language is English, so for which, you know, I'll be keeping this all default, and then just simply click on OK. And now this is basically our license agreement, so for which, you know, I'll be basically selecting this accept license agreement, and then simply click on next. And now if you have time, you can read this information. I'll be, you know, simply clicking on next. This is basically the directory where this WAMP Server is basically going to be installed, that is this WAMP Server 64. And you need to have at least 273 MB of free disk space. So you need to have this amount of disk space free in your C directory. If you want to change your installation destination, then you can just simply click on browse and you can change your installation destination. Otherwise, you know, I'll be just simply keeping this all default, and then just simply click on next. And this is basically, you know, this default installation. So they're basically going to install MySQL 5.7.31, MariaDB 10.4.13, and this PHP version. If you want to, you know, customize your installation, then just simply, you know, simply select on this and then select custom installation, and you can choose your version. Otherwise, you know, what I'll be doing is in this video I'll be keeping this all default, and then just simply click on next. If you are a beginner, then I'll recommend not to do any custom installation. This default installation is going to be absolutely fine. And also one more thing, you need to have an additional 1.94 GB of free disk space. This is very important. This is where, you know, this database is going to be installed. So you need to have approximately about 2 GB of free disk space in your directory, right? And now just simply click on next. And this is basically going to be your server directory. So keep this all default, and then just simply click on next. So these are the files that are going to be installed. That is this PHP 7.4.9 is the version that going to be installed. Then MariaDB 10.4.13 and MySQL 5.7.31. And this PHP MyAdmin version is 5.0.2. and then this WAMP server 64, right? So just simply, you know, simply select on this install for installation. And now, as you can see, this installation has been, you know, rightly began. It will take a minute or two, so for which, you know, I'll be coming back once when it gets done. Yeah. So welcome back. And now, as you can see, a pop-up came from this WAMP server installation that this Internet Explorer is basically our default browser. So what we'll be doing is we'll be you know, going to change this default browser to Chrome. You can, you know, change this to Mozilla or any other browser that you want to use, but Windows Explorer is not a good option, I would say. So for that, just simply go to your C directory and then go to program files and then Google, and here you'll be seeing this Chrome. If you want to use other browser like Mozilla or any other browser, then you'll be getting that folder over here. So what I'll be doing is I'll be, you know, selecting this Chrome, then application, and this is basically, you know, our exe file, Chrome exe file. So I'll be, you know, selecting this and then simply click on open. And then it's basically asking that Notepad is basically our default text editor. So for which, you know, I am also going to change this to Sublime Text. I have also made a video on how to install Sublime Text. So if you haven't installed Sublime Text, then you can just go to this I button and you can install Sublime Text. It's a very good editor, I would say. So what I'll be doing is, you know, I'll be selecting this yes, and then I'll again go to our C directory, then program files. Just scroll down a bit and here you'll be seeing the Sublime Text 3. I'll be basically going to select that, and this is basically our Sublime Text exe file. So just, you know, simply select this and select on open. This is not a compulsory step, you can always do that later, but you know, I am going to set this at default during installation. You can always do that later. And this is basically, you know, final phase of our this installation. That is, it's saying that about 30 seconds left for installation. I'll be, you know, first forwarding this. And now, as you can see, this installation is almost completed, and it's basically saying that if you go to this directory, you'll be seeing this instruction for use, and also this MariaDB MySQL.txt. I'll be, you know, simply clicking on next and then simply click on finish. And now, as you can see, this WAMP server has been, you know, rightly installed and is in our desktop icon. So what I'll be doing is, you know, I'll be just simply double click on it to launch this WAMP server. As you can see, this WAMP server is now, you know, currently running, and its color has been, you know, changed to red to yellow, and then it's also going to change to green within a moment. So as you can see, this WAMP server is now currently, you know, turned into green, so it's running properly. Now just simply go to your browser and open a new tab, and in here, if you just simply type localhost, then enter, you'll be seeing this page, WAMP server. So all this page means is that your WAMP server has been, you know, rightly installed, right? So I will be also showing you how to run a PHP file in this WAMP server. So for that, just simply open a text editor. I am going to use Sublime Text. You can use any text editor. And in here, what I'll be doing is I'll be creating a new project. So for that, just simply go to file, then click on this open folder. And in here, you need to go to C directory first. So just simply click on C directory, then scroll down a bit, and you'll be seeing this WAMP 64 folder. So just, you know, simply double click on it. And here you'll be seeing this www folder. This is very important. Just simply go inside that folder, and here you create new project. So this is very important, guys. You need to create project only under this www folder. For WAMP server, this www folder is very, very important. Always remember this folder name, right? So just simply click on new folder, and here give a new project name as Hello World App. Just simply, you know, select folder. So you'll be seeing that this folder has been, you know, rightly selected over here. So what I'll be doing is I'll be creating a new file. So file, new file. And here I'll be simply writing a simple code snippet in PHP. So PHP. And here what I'll be doing is I'll be, you know, simply printing Hello World. And here, as you can see, this hello world has been, you know, rightly shown in our browser. You can also change this to hello world to hello everyone. Then just, you know, again go to file and save, and again if you just go to browser and just simply reload it, you'll be seeing this hello everyone. So that's all for this video, friends. I have shown you rightly how to install WAMP server in your Windows 10 operating system. So that's all for this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please give it a like and also do share with your friends. Once again, thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.